Okie dokie artichokey, beautiful people, what is going on? Welcome to a special edition, because we got a special live this week, because we're doing it a day early, because we're not going to be here tomorrow. So I figured I still want to get this up, I still want to do these lives. This is the best part of my week. Hopefully it's a cool part of your week too. And yeah, I'd love to know a few things as you're tuning in. I'd love to know what your first name is. I'd love to know where you're tuning in from. And then I'd also love to know something really, really, really good that's going on in your life right now, okay? So I will kickstart this so you know how we run these things. It's not gonna be any different. It's just a day earlier, so don't worry, okay? So my name is Connor, if you don't know. I am from Pittsburgh. And something really, really, really good that's going on in my life right now is that we're going on a little trip tomorrow. And something else that's really good in my life is we got a haircut yesterday, okay? And we started a new book. We started this guy, 10X is easier than 2X. And that's what we're going to be talking kind of about today, okay? So as you're tuning in, let me know what your first name is, let me know where you're tuning in from, and then let me know something really, really good that's going on in your life right now, and then we're gonna talk. I forgot to put the topic, so I don't even know if it's gonna show the topic or not, but the topic of today's live is going to be, it's gonna be about sucking, because it's something that I've certainly been dealing with, sucking, and then we're gonna talk about some things I'm getting from my reading today. And just give you some encouragement if you are like a beginner, you're beginning anything that you're starting right now, okay? So let's see who we got. So like I said, I'm Connor, I'm from Pittsburgh, and I just got my haircut yesterday, okay? So we got Riley from DC. What is going on, Riley? Long time no see. Who else do we have here? Melanie from Florida. We love that, Melanie. We've got Sarah in the house. Mom, something about the ghost bike trail today. Cool. That sounds cool. We got Leah in the house. We got Holly in the house. Hi, Connor. I'm Claire from Zimbabwe. But living in England, one good thing going on in my life is I'm alive today and I'm grateful. I love that, Claire. That is cool. It's a cool little crossover, cool little collab, Zimbabwe, but living in England. We love that. What is going on, Sarah? Jennifer from Texas, grad school is almost done. Let's go, Jennifer. Crank that out. Almost done. Holly's from Montreal. Let's go. Canada in the house. Danica crushed her workouts, crushed 20 box jumps. Let's go, Danica. You're just out here killing it, making it look easy, okay? We got Levi from Australia. I'm blessed to have such an amazing family. Amen to that. Cora from California. What is going on, Cora? What part of California? We got Abby from Maryland. Just started a podcast. Let's freaking go, Abby. What kind of podcast is it? I don't know if we've ever had someone from Maryland so far. We got Jafia in the house. Happy Thursday. One good thing is that I'm thinking about moving to the U.S. for my career. Torn between L.A. and Miami. Well, if I have anything to say about it, I would say L.A. I don't even think I've ever been to Miami. We got Melissa from Pittsburgh, fellow Pittsburgh in the house, heading to aerobics now that I've recovered from a meniscus tear. Let's go. First aerobics class since the meniscus tear. Hopefully it goes well and it's safe, okay? We got Karen from Washington, have to go back to work now. I'll catch the replay. All right, we'll catch the replay, okay? I'll post this after, okay? Cool. All right, so Sam from San Diego just got into film school. Let's go, Sam. You're killing it out here. All right, so I got some fun facts for you, okay? That's a new addition to these lives that I'm pulling out. We got another Los Angelino in the house. And so, yeah. So I got some fun facts for you guys, okay? So Angie from Minnesota, happy to be alive. Life is so good. Absolutely. Amen, Angie. So podcast mostly about growth and having a positive perspective on life as you're growing. All right. I like that. I'm all about that. All right. So yeah. Maybe this could be like, who knows? We're like testing out sometimes. Like maybe this could be like the time that we do our lives every week. I don't know. Maybe Fridays are better. Who knows? So, I don't know. Thursdays, Fridays, like, I don't know what you guys like, but, Yeah, so we got some fun facts for you guys today, and then we'll get started into like the juicy stuff, okay? First fun fact of this week is that I tore my pants. We split our pants a couple days ago. It's like the fifth or sixth time I've done this, and I've done this with like work pants. I've done this with work workout pants, like sweatpants and stuff. Those were the pants that I split my pants with. So I don't know if you guys have ever done that. I did a poll a couple days ago on my story, but that was a fun fact for me. I think that was actually 2 days ago. Yeah, that was Tuesday. So that's the first one. And then the second fun fact is actually about hair, okay? So this was something that when I went to get my haircut, it means you're making progress. Exactly. So we're doing something right, I guess, right? When it comes to leg day at least, okay? So whenever I got my haircut yesterday, I go to the same hairstylist every single week, or not every single week, every single month. And I was thinking about some things, like, I don't know, you just have like small talk, I'm sure, when you get your haircut or if you go to your hairstylist and stuff like that, you know. I don't know, I'm there for like 30 minutes, so we just like chit chat. And I was like, I'm gonna ask him some questions about hair, because if there's gonna be someone that knows like the answers to these that I'd probably want, it's gonna be him, right? So I go to him like, I needed some advice on like how often I should be shampooing, how often I should be using conditioner, and then how I should like be, what kind of product I should be using in my hair, okay? So I was like, yeah, how, like, what are your like tips on this? So this is what he told me, okay? So he told me that I don't have like the thickest hair in the game, okay? I got like thinner hair as opposed to like thick hair, right? So if you have like thinner hair as opposed to thicker hair like me, he said you want to be shampooing like 3 times a week, basically, okay? And you want to shampoo like when you're shampooing, basically every other day. That's what I'm doing. And you want to shampoo at your roots, okay? Like the root of your hair when you're shampooing, okay? So that's the first thing, okay? The second thing is that he told me that I don't necessarily have to be using conditioner, but if I wanted to, which I don't think I'm going to, you want to use conditioner at like the ends of your hair, okay? But like shampoo at the roots and use conditioner at the ends, like the tips of your hair, okay? And then the third thing was like for product, basically, he told me that I should be, I bought something he recommended for me that he recommended for like my kind of hair. But he said like, after like blow drying my hair dry, like I do that every single, whenever I shower, like every day, I'll blow dry it and then I'll put like product in, basically. And he said to put product in when it's like 80% of the way dry, okay? So, and then it just holds better if it's like still a little bit wet, and it just dries that way, okay? So those are my fun facts. And then also, he told me never to use hairspray. Okay, so those are my like fun facts I learned from getting my haircut yesterday, okay? So I just wanted to share that with you. I wanted to share that I ripped my pants this week. And I also wanted to share my tips that I got from my hairstylist when I got my haircut yesterday, okay? So we got Portugal in the house. What is going on, Portugal? So so let's get into what I want to talk about today on today's live, okay? So we're going to talk about some fun things. We're going to talk about how I've been sucking at some things, but I've gotten better at not sucking at some things. And just give you guys some encouragement if you're like beginning something and you're like super sucky at it right now and you're trying to get better at it. And you want to stick with it because you want to get better at it, right? And you want to suck a little bit less, okay? So that's what we're going to be talking about today. So let's get into it, okay? So about 4 months ago, I decided to do something crazy. I decided to sign up for a race, okay? So probably around that same time, it was like a week or two before this, I did a powerlifting meet, and I'd never done one of those in my life, but I was like, I want to do one of these, and I want to like see how strong I can get. So I did that about 4 months ago, and then when that was done, I was like, I want to sign up for a race, okay? So about a year ago, I did a marathon. I'd never done one of those before, and then like 4 months ago, I did a powerlifting meet, And so I was like, okay, I want my like next challenge, you know? So I decided to sign up for a half Ironman. So we're about, that was 4 months ago, okay? And so we've been training for the last 4 months. We've got one more month essentially left, a little over a month left before race day. And if you don't know what a half Ironman entails, it is 70.3 miles is the total distance, okay? And you have a 1.2 mile swim, you have a 56 mile bike ride, and then you have a 13.1 mile run, which is basically a half marathon, okay? So the race that I'm doing is called, it's in Long Beach, California, so it's called Bayshore 70.3. And that's what we've been training for the past 4 months, okay? And so when I signed up for this, I was super like, I was kind of hesitant to do this because I'm like not in the, I was not in the best shape. Like I was like prepping for a powerlifting meet. I was trying to get strong. So I was like the heaviest I've ever been. So I was like 210, 215 pounds whenever I signed up for this, right? And it was super like, I was super sort of intimidated, right? If you guys ever felt that way, whenever you're like committing to something like that, whether it's like a physical challenge or a fitness challenge or like financial commitment or something like that you're making, right? So I was like, am I going to be able to like prep for this, train for this? Am I going to be able to like complete this, right? I just want to finish it, right? That was like my initial goal. So when I signed up for this, like I kid you not, I have not swam, like literally swam laps in a pool or ridden a bike for that matter in probably since freshman year of high school, right? let's go, Jafia. And so I literally haven't swam in a pool since like when I had to do swimming in gym class in freshman year of high school. And pretty much I haven't ridden a bike pretty much probably around that time too. So obviously I needed to like get better at these things if I was gonna even like finish this thing coming up, right? So there's I remember just the first day when I hopped into the pool. So there's a pool at this at my apartment complex that I live at, and it's kind of funny because where the pool is at, let's go, Danica. Danica says I've done a half marathon, signed up, showed up, and ran it, no training, and killed it. Let's freaking go, Danica. You are a beast. So I have this pool in my apartment complex, and the first day I had to do my swimming, I think I just had to do like, I think it was like 10 minutes of a swim, you know? And so where my pool is, there's a gym where I work out at every single day, and it kind of like overlooks the pool, like all like the cardio equipment like overlooks the pool. And so all like, you know, if you're in the pool swimming, like everyone's seeing you, everyone's watching you, and there's no way around it, right? So I remember the first day I had to like swim for 10 minutes straight, and I literally almost drowned, I swear. and so I was like super, I was like, you know, I was like, everyone's watching me suck at this. Like I'm sucking so hard at like swimming, but I was like learning. Like I hadn't done this in like 12 years basically. So, I was like, I'm committed to like figuring out how to do this. Right. I was just like going super hard. And I was like, how am I going to ever swim for basically an hour straight to like finish this part of this race, you know? So that was 4 months ago. Right. And you know, it was not like the best feeling to have people like watching you suck at what you're doing for the entire time that you're trying to do it, you know? So, even though like, you know, not that like people would like, not that like it mattered or anything like that. It was just like, it didn't help the case that like people were watching me as I was struggling. You know what I mean? So, that kind of leads me into this next point I wanted to get to. And it was something I actually saw. I don't know if you guys have heard of this or not, but I think it talks about in the book. I don't know if you've heard of the book called Atomic Habits or not. Jafia, I stopped swimming in 2009 and I've been thinking about starting lessons again. Let's go, Jafia. And so I actually saw this. It was a guy by the name of Jesse Itzler. I saw on Instagram posted about this, and he was talking about like how it takes 100 days to basically develop a habit. And he was talking about the law of 100, okay? And so what the law of 100 says is that Basically, if you were to spend 100 hours in an entire year at committing 100 hours to like any discipline that you want to get better at, okay? And so if you were to commit 100 hours throughout the entire course of the year, that would actually, and you were to like actually do that and follow through with that commitment, you would be better than 95% of, you know, everybody, basically, of the entire world. You'd be better than 95% of the entire world at that discipline, okay? So basically, you'd be top 5% if you spent 100 hours in an entire year, if you committed to that time to like any discipline, right? If it's like a fitness goal you want to get better at, if it's like learning a language or learning a musical instrument or studying for like something, I don't know, a skill that you want to get better at. But for me, it was like, I wanted to get better at swimming. I wanted to get better at biking. I wanted to get better at running so I could finish this race that I'm doing in like a month, okay? So what 100 hours in the course of a year, if you were to spread that out over the course of a year, here's where I wanna bring it like full circle when it comes to like maybe just encouraging you when it comes to how little of time that is on a daily basis, right? So if you were to take 100 hours over the course of 365 days, it's really only, it's exactly about 16 and a half minutes per day, right? So if you want to get better at like one thing, right? Like for me, it was like, I need to get better at swimming, you know, swimming, biking, and running basically. So if I wanted to be top 5% in the world, in the entire world at those things, then I just needed to commit 15 minutes, let's say 15 minutes per day to getting a little bit better each and every day. And I just had to do that over the course of a year, right? So I've done that over the course of 4 months. And whenever I was first starting, like swimming in the pool, literally could barely even finish 10 minutes without like dying and almost drowning in the pool, right? Now I'm swimming like 4 feet of depth of a swimming pool, right? So it's not like I had to like, I don't even know what the term is. Like, what's like the word you use when you're like in the deep end and you have to like hold yourself up in the swimming pool? Like, what's that word? Like, I have no idea what this word is. I don't even know why I can't think of this word. But like I could stand in the pool basically. Like, it's not like I had to, you know, keep myself up on the pool. Dude, I cannot think of this word. treading. Yes. Treading water. I could not think of that for the life of me. So yeah, I was like, you know, so basically treading water. Thank you, Bella, for that. So, it's not like I had to tread water or I was going to drown or something. I could just stand in the pool. You know what I mean? But I think it, like full circle, I just wanted to kind of mention that and make that the topic of this live, because, you know, if there's anything like when it comes to maybe it's like a fitness goal and you're like super, you haven't worked on your fitness, you haven't been working on your fitness in a long time. It's been a minute since you've a few minutes since you've been working on your fitness or your health or whatever that means for overall health and wellness. And like, it literally only takes, it doesn't take like, it takes a lot less time than you think when it comes to like on the daily. If you were to commit to something, doing it on the daily basis, like it only commits 15 minutes a day. It only takes 15 minutes a day, to actually improve. And if you want to become like an elite, you know, not even an elite person, but like top 5% in the world of something, if you were to commit to something for 15 minutes a day for the entire year, you would get there, you know? So it's not like, it's just the consistency of like basically the compound effect, another great book, of doing it every single day, day in and day out, regardless of how you feel. It just takes 15 minutes a day, right? So like you could be reading a book, and like I'm a pretty slow reader. I like was a pretty slow reader, still sort of am. But I was like, I want to start getting better at reading because like I think these books can help me, you know, improve and grow. So 2 years ago, like I committed to reading like 10 pages a day, and now we do 20 pages a day. And 10 pages a day took me 20 minutes to do, right? So it was like, I did that all last year and pretty much up until this point. It took me 20 minutes a day and I have not missed a day. And now I'm so much better at reading, you know? I feel like I'm a lot better at I'm 100% more literate, and I feel like I'm a lot more articulate too because I did that, right? So, yeah, and then just the next thing I wanted to mention, actually, which I got from this book, was talking about the Pareto principle. So I don't know if you've ever learned about this. I actually learned about this in school, but it basically can apply to anything. So what the Pareto principle is that it basically states that 20% of your efforts will produce 80% of your results. So you can apply that to literally anything in the world, right? So 20% of your efforts in anything is going to produce 80% of the outcomes or the results of whatever you're trying to do, okay? So basically when it comes back to those 100 hours that I was kind of speaking to when it comes to the law of 100, so, you know, if you were to think about the Pareto principle of like 20-80, it's basically like just getting through those first 20 hours of doing whatever you want to do and sucking through those first 20 hours. And if you can just get yourself, like, it's kind of just how quickly you can get, allow yourself, push yourself, force yourself to get through those first 20 hours to produce 80% of the results of your progress and your growth. So the reason I wanted to talk about that is because 4 months, I've basically spent 20 hours, essentially 20 hours swimming, 20 hours biking, 20 hours running over the past 4 months in each of those things. And essentially I've gotten 80% better. I'm 80% of the way towards being top 5% half Ironman athlete, if you want to think of it like that, right? And so it's just kind of like not judging yourself when you're first starting out, understanding you're not going to be perfect when you start out. You're actually going to be like the farthest away from perfect that you possibly imagine. you'll be in the negatives when it comes to like how good you'll be, when it comes to, oh, like I want to go to school and study a certain subject. Oh, like I actually know negative amount of material when it comes to this discipline or something like that, right? Or it's like, I want to learn a new language. It's like, I don't know a single word in a different language. If you want to lose weight or grow, you know, get in better shape or put on some muscle or something like that, tone up, it's get allowing yourself or learning how to sell or working a certain job or career or something. It's getting through the first 20 hours, like just getting those under your belt and realizing like, I'm not going to judge myself. I know this first hour is going to be the worst. It's only going to get better. The next 19 hours is going to count for the next 75 to 80% of my progress. And by the time you get to 20 hours, like you'll basically be top 5%, a professional, essentially, if that's going to count for 80% of your growth and your progress towards that goal, you'll basically be top 10% in whatever discipline that is, okay? So overall takeaways, I don't want to make this any too much longer because I feel like it's hidden pretty quick, is like, just to give you some encouragement, like I sucked at what I was trying to do whenever I first started, whenever I like signed up for this race, I was super kind of scared. I was like, oh, I don't even know if I know how to swim anymore. I don't even know if I know how to ride a bike anymore. I don't even know if I can run like I used to run, you know? And it just took me 20 hours to just get 80% better, essentially, right? Almost twofold better from where I started, right? Now I'm not drowning when I swim. I can swim for an hour straight. We just did that yesterday. It was hard, but we didn't drown, okay? You know, so now I can like run. We're gonna be running, I think, a half marathon next week is kind of like in my training. So we're gonna be doing that next week. And it's like, I can do that, you know? We will do that. And so it's just going easy on yourself when you're first starting out, and there's really like nothing you can do if you can just get through 20 hours of like anything you want to do, anything you want to pursue, any discipline you want to get better at, anything you want to learn. And so that's all I wanted to say. So that's all I got for you guys. I hope this helped you, and I will probably see you guys next Friday. I'll take a peek at the analytics that I get from this live, see if it's any better than Friday's. But we're probably going to keep it on Fridays going forward, okay? So Friday at 3 p.m. PST, okay? All right. Love you guys always. Have a safe weekend, and I'll see you soon, okay? Peace.